How are you today? This is El Latino Brown for What's Your Story? Hey, everybody. All right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Listen, we have an exciting show today. It's all about fathers. My guest list is very, very special today. I have with me in the studio one of rock and roll's biggest rising superstars and a legacy family member of the biggest rock and roller of them all, Mr. Elvis Presley. I'm also going to be joined by Quincy Jones Jr., okay? He'll be here. And also, we have in the house Funkalicious, but right now, we're waiting to hear from the man who has to deliver a message all about family from Mr. Richard Stefani. Richard, are you there?
I am, sir.
All right, Richard, how you doing? You said you had something special for fathers today that nobody has ever heard. Ladies and gentlemen, sit in your seats, turn everything off. Let's listen to Mr. Stefani. Richard, you have the floor.
Well, Jay, what can I say about Father's Day? Basically, I'm a father. I have four children. We homeschool all four. And that's a tremendous sacrifice for us financially because my wife, being a professional, could easily earn enough money that would give us a lifestyle that one would be envious of. But because we have to live off my income and mine alone and by the grace of God, we make do without my wife's professional income. So it's a sacrifice for us. And, I made a commitment later in life, because I did get married later in life. My first child was born when I was 49 years old. My oldest is now 16, so you kind of get a handle as to how old I am. But I'm just, I'm here at the house. My office is here. I gave up my fancy Beverly Hills penthouse on Wilshire Boulevard so that I could live in the suburbs and have my office out of the house so I could be here with my kids. And that's a sacrifice I've made. And, I've spoken with a number of other men, and I'm not alone in this. So I don't want the listening audience to think I'm some kind of father guru, because I'm not. I'm, because of the fact that I got married later in life and had my children later, I guess I came to appreciate that, which so many men are privileged to experience at a younger age. But there's no perfect age to become a father. God dictates, what circumstances you get to choose. And if you choose rightly, then you get blessed. If you choose wrongly, well, then you suffer the consequences of that. But in the course of me being a father, I've come to understand that a father's role for his children is actually more important and more impactful than a mother's role. Now, for many in the listening audience, that's going to seem very controversial and somewhat sexist. But let me share with you why I believe that. For a daughter, my daughter is going to be raised up to be a woman, I hope a godly woman, and she's going to look at me and hopefully hold other men to the standard that I'm trying to live by. And I pray that she will look at other men and say, I want to marry a man like my dad, with the integrity, with the strength, with the kindness of my father. So I'm basically a role model for the type of man that is going to carry her across the threshold, that's going to walk her down the aisle, to whom I am going to give over and say, my daughter is now yours. So I hope to be that role model. For my son, I hope to be that same kind of role model where my two boys will say, I want to be like my dad. I want to be strong like him. I want to care for the family like him. Because if I'm not that kind of role model, see, my boys only have two choices. Either I want to be like my dad, or I don't want to be anything like my dad. Because I've known men who have grown up, say, gosh, my dad was an alcoholic. He was an abuser. He was a womanizer. I don't want to be anything like him. I don't want to be that kind of role model. I want to be the kind of role model that my daughters look to and say, I want to marry that kind of man. And that my boys say, I want to be that kind of man so that I can attract a godly woman that I can cherish and be the kind of father that my dad was to me. The mother is the nurturer. She's great. She's wonderful. The family is blessed to have her. She's essential. But she does not have the impact of the role model that the father has. And that's why I say, you know, father is the most crucial element in the family. But there's no secret as to, or mystery as to why 70% of the prison population are raised in families without fathers. It is no mystery that when prisoners were asked to write a Mother's Day card, they did. There was a study where 500 prisoners were given a Mother's Day card, and every single one of them, to the man, wrote a Mother's Day card. When Father's Day came around the following month, and they were offered the same free card to write a Father's Day card to their father, not one of the 500 inmates wrote a Father's Day card. Wow. Folks, wow. That's tragic. That's tearful. That's heartbreaking. We as a nation have to come and rise up and be a nation of fathers, a nation where we nurture our children and raise them up to be godly men and women that regardless of their career paths, because quite frankly, I don't care what my kids do for a living, as long as they honor God first and enter into an arena where God has placed them, whether it be in a professional life, whether it be in academia, whether it be in business. You know, I don't care. I just want my boys to be men of God, strong men, men of integrity,
amen,
and controversial men. Because, you know what, being a father is controversial.
Amen.
It is doing those things that the secular world says that, oh, man, you're narrow-minded. Okay?
Wow.
You're too strict. Okay? You need to go with the flow. Well, I don't want my kids to go with the flow, because the flow is drugs and sex outside of marriage and, you know, illicit relationships and lack of values. That's what going with the flow means. I don't want my boys going with the flow.
Amen.
Don't want my girls going with the flow. My job is to be a dad to set a standard. So, folks, that's my Father's Day message. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Richard. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Words of inspiration. Okay, well, moving right along, I'm sure Wascal will be up and running soon because everybody wants to learn how to rascal. So we're going to be sending those starting this week on How to Wascal.
Great. We'll be sending out some tutorials. We have a number of publishers that are coming on board every day. We just added 4 more publishers over the weekend, so that puts us at 41.
Wow.
And, folks, just as a side note, we have some major, major television channels that are with whom we are in negotiations right now that will be on Wascal. Why? Why would a major television channel think about coming on to Wascal? And the answer is this: because we have what they cannot have technologically. We have the multi-screen experience. We have second screen experience. We have direct product placement. We have the ability for the viewer to choose what camera angle they want to see. Oh, my gosh, folks. Well, we have that, and that is operational today, that some of these large networks are looking for, and they don't have to invent it, and it's free. All you have to do is come Wascal. Wascal is free TV. The way TV was meant to be. So they don't have to pay for it. Now, what do you think the chances are of them coming on board?
I think it's excellent. Like I said, you know, we're going to perfect it as best we can before it's released to everyone. So patience. And we'll have delivered the best quality that you'll ever see anywhere. And guess what? It's free.
It's free. Free TV. The way TV was meant to be.
Amen.
So,
thank you so much, Richard.
You're very welcome, Alatino. Thank you for this opportunity to share my heart of what fatherhood means to me. I thank you very much for the opportunity.
You're welcome, sir. Anytime, pop in my show. Anytime, Richard. Tell us the latest going on with Wascal, and we'll do the same for you.
Great. Thank you.
All right,
Alatino. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Okay. Now, I'd like to take the pleasure of introducing a young lady that's very, very special to me. Even though she has none of her my blood rushing through her veins, she has the spirit of my life as well as what it takes to make this world a better place. So without further ado, I would like to introduce to you Miss Sonia Love Music Harley. My daughter.
Hey. What's up, Dad?
Hi, sweetheart. How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Well, you know, I remember bringing you to a studio very much like this one. Oh, it is the same one, isn't it?
Yes, actually it is.
So this was one of your first experiences with actual podcasting, I remember.
Yeah, and it was awesome. It was amazing. It was like a room filled with people, and we were talking about topics from A to Z, and I was just sitting there soaking it all in and amazed at the fact that you brought me in. I believe it was with the Easy Show.
That's
and it
correct.
Was super fun.
Right.
And since then, the journey has been a ride. And now here we are talking about Father's Day. And so you're like my honorary dad. And I feel really, really, really special about that because I know that you have advice to give me that my actual real dad doesn't have because, you know, he's a pastor. And so I come from a strong Christian background, which actually your last interview with Richard, a lot of the things that he was saying was really hit home with me. I totally understand what he is talking about as far as men having that type of strong character and value of life and then raising his daughters that way. So I totally get it. But yeah, thanks to you, I'm here with you right now.
Amen. And what a blessing. Sonia, let me ask you a question. Do you remember the first time we laid eyes on each other?
Yeah, the first time I met you was at Mel's Diner.
That is
on Sunset, because I had just finished doing like a show with some, watching a show with some friends, and then going to the, I believe it was fashion. It was a red carpet for the.
Right, and also David Harris and Levi's birthday.
Oh yeah. Ah, okay, and I met him. That night as well.
Right.
Yeah, right on.
Okay. Well, we've come a long way in the last 3.5 to 4 years. And I want to tell a little bit about yourself. You are a rock and roller from the heart, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Tell us about, we both had friends that one you knew very well, one I knew very well, but was a part of your life when we did What's Your Story back at the old studio. Do you remember? Miss Jill Kelsey.
Oh, yeah, from Modier.
That's correct.
Yeah.
She recently passed. One moment for a quick silent prayer for her and her family at this point. Jill, we'll miss you and we love you.
Yeah. Your spirit's resting in a better place.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Thank you. And also, all the people that are, I mean, Prince is gone. Muhammad Ali. Michael Jackson.
A lot of greats, actually. It's really interesting how, like, the people that have passed away over the past couple of months have been, like, groundbreakers, you know? They've been people that weren't afraid to push the fabric of music and of mankind, actually, breaking and, like, bringing people together in ways that no one could think possible. I think that's what music does. Like, the best way to reach a multitude of people is through music because it's a spiritual thing, you know? So a lot of the people that are passing away lately, it seems like a lot of them are artists, you know?
Right.
Michael Jackson. Yeah.
So, unfortunately, I don't think we had enough time to get one of your clips unless you have one on Facebook or something that you can pull up. Do you have a clip, Sonia? Or we could play it a little bit later if you just
have
to. We could
play it a little later, yeah.
Okay,
we could
great.
Pull something up, of course.
Okay, Sonia, what nobody has ever done out there, hint, hint, all you podcasters, no one has had an exclusive interview with me. And unfortunately, on the last show we shot in the studio, it wasn't put in. So, Sonia,
yes.
What questions do you have for your dad if you're going to interview me? And this was your show, Rocket to the Stars. I'll be your first guest.
You'll be my first guest.
Yes.
On Rocket to the Stars.
Yes. So introducing Sonia Harley, Rocket to the Stars.
Rocket to the Stars. All right, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Woo-hoo! Yes. Thank you for joining in to Rocket to the Stars, being that Father's Day is right around the corner. I have got an amazing, amazing guest today by the name of Alatino Brown. And he is a mover, a shaker, and he's definitely a person that likes to get things started. And if he sees talent in someone, he's 100% there trying to help them, motivate them, and mold them into a better person. So, which he kind of did with me. So, I have him today on my show, Rocket to the Stars, because he's definitely a star looking down on all the people that he would like to call children in one sense or another. So, Alatino, my first question to you is, do you have any children of your own?
Yes, I do. I have 4 boys and 4 grandchildren, 3 boys and 1 granddaughter.
Wow. You're a granddaddy too?
Yes.
Awesome. That is super cool. So what's your relationship with your kids? Do they listen to you?
Well, when they don't, they usually wind up getting in trouble. My youngest, I've never had a problem out of him at all. All the rest of my kids are pretty cool kids. From what I know about them and what they've allowed them to share with me. But we're all on pretty good terms at this point in our lives.
That's good. Well, you know, I know that you're very talented because you were a dancer on Soul Train, right?
That is absolutely correct.
So with me, see, I did my homework just a little bit. Yeah. No. But with me knowing that, so what about your children? Like, are they involved in any type of, like, entertainment things?
Well, my oldest, Brandon, he's devoted to school.
Okay.
He is continuing to learn everything that there is. And he's about 37 right now, and he's still in school.
Wow, awesome.
He's a professional student out in Florida. My second son, Chris, he's into music and acting and, you know, trying to raise his daughter, which is my granddaughter.
Okay.
And they should be getting together Sunday, and we should have more clips on the very next show I promised to share.
Oh, awesome. That is super cool. So let's travel back before cyberspace media, which is one of your something that you came up with that's very helpful and an outlet for a lot of people. When you were a Soul Train dancer on Soul Train, did you project forward and know that you were going to be like doing things that would allow other people to express their talents as well?
No, I didn't. When I was doing Soul Train, I was into my computer career. I would say I was 6 years in, and by the time Soul Train was over for me, I had made another 12 years in computer science, communication, and networking. And I really, you know, got tired of the suit and tie and always being Mr. Prim and Proper. I wanted to let my hair down, you know, get out there and shake a wild thing, you know. And so one weekend a month, I went to Soul Train religiously. And I did like to dance because of my martial arts background. Okay. And it was what I did to exercise when I wasn't sitting behind a desk in office all day, 16 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Wow. You know what? That's what it is. That's why you can attract like younger people, because you have that energy, you know, and it's alive and it's cool. You're not a stale person, you know, and you seem like you're not afraid to take like any chances at all, which is super cool, because we like the daredevil in people, especially the younger generation. We're kind of like, hey, get out there and just do it and make it happen, because that's what it's all about. Like, you have the internet and everything, you know, you don't have to go everywhere for everything. It's like you basically right in front of you. So what made you come up with cyberspace media?
Well, as you know, when I got to Hollywood, so to speak, I was doing all the charity benefits, and I ran into a very interesting gentleman, Easy, and he invited me in into this very studio, in fact.
Yay,
and,
Easy.
Yeah, all right, Easy, yeah. So anyway, he brought out what was always there in me to help other people. But also remember, my computers, I could only do so much one-on-one. I wanted to be able to reach a larger audience. And through media, or social media as we call it today, I was able to combine my talents of computers and social media skills and talking to people and just attending all these events to amass people. And when I was doing my first red carpet show, I learned what it was to get in front of a camera and speak, even though I was scared to death.
Yeah. Now I'm not shy anymore. We got there, party.
But I really was the very first time I had stage fright. And thank you for asking. The other reason I created Cyberspace Media, and all the media people out there, Bob DiLigato, Mark Sevier, Sherry Diederman, Kigbasi, Guzman, all of them were, you know, they would always take the time to single me out and take the time to promote me. And I really appreciate them. Thank you, guys. I really do appreciate you. You know?
Okay. That is super cool.
Right.
So yeah, it's good to hear.
Because of that, that cost Cyberspace Media, just to get out there and gather the media. And, of course, now Cyberspace Media has a website with Richard Stefani. We have our own TV network. And it's for children and for all indie all the time. And teaming up with Roscoe's Media Center, Y'all Radio, we're just going to grow and grow and grow until we just burst at the seams and all these superstars will illuminate our galaxy. And that's really what I want to do. And that's why your Rocket to the Stars is imperative that we get started so I can pass the torch to you, my entertainment daughter.
Well, I'm excited, actually, to get started with the whole Rocket to the Stars, you know, especially... Rocket to the Stars!
Yeah.
After doing the tour, you know, with Motorhead, Anthrax, Slayer, Suicidal Tendencies, my band played and we had such a blast, and we just recently played for the Ronnie James Dio Stand Up and Shout Cancer Fund.
Yes, which, I was there.
Yeah, and you were there, and that was Lita Ford and the Dio Disciples and Butterside. Actually, they'll be playing tonight at the Whiskey in Hollywood. But yeah, so I am very, very grateful at the fact that we were able to cross paths because since meeting you, I had my show on The Easy Show. So we had a music show on that show, and then that show kind of fizzed away, and everyone just sort of went and I guess focused on the next steps. And so now here we are. This is the next step. I'm here with you interviewing you today. I'm excited about that. Talking about Cyberspace Media, what's your story, and then Rocket to the Stars.
Right.
I'm really excited to get started with that. I have a lot of people in mind actually to bring on the show. So it's going to be super freaking fun.
Great. Well, thank you so much. We'll go into more and more of each of our lives as we progress. But right now, I am ready to take a commercial break, and we'll be taking our sponsors, and we'll be right back. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Of dawn, gotta get ready to start my day. 16 hours of long, hard work, so I can receive my pay. Gotta do this, gotta do that. Find myself picking up the slack. For those who don't know about this weekend, don't sit behind your desk. Come party with us this weekend.
I get those happy feels
when the weekend comes around.
My body breaks a beat
and I just can't settle down.
I get those happy feels
when the weekend comes around.
'Cause I work all week
and I just can't settle down. Don't wear no suit or shirt or tie. This job description does not require, but all you need is the will to do all the jobs no one else wants to do.
Lazy people,
I just can't wait for quitting time. Me and the boys, we have girls on the line.
Yeah.
Go to the club and get my groove on and dance to the music. But when the weekend comes around,
'cause I work hard all week, I get those happy feet.
But when the weekend comes around,
my body breaks a beat, I get those happy feet, 'cause I work hard all week.
Ooh, I like to go to the club and find me a nice lady. I'm not stiff and I'm not shady. I like the girls who looking real good 'cause I worked hard all week. Come here, little girl, let me kiss you on your cheek.
I get those happy feels
when the weekend comes. comes around.
My body makes a beat,
and I just can't settle down.
I get those happy feet
when the weekend comes around.
Cause I work all week,
and I just wanna get down.
I get those happy feet
when the weekend comes around.
My body makes a beat. I get those happy feet. Cause I work all week.
I'm getting the happy feet. I'm feeling the rhythm in the beat. I'm getting those happy feet. Cause I worked hard on me. No happy feet. I worked hard on me. I wanna get my groove on. I wanna get my groove on. I wanna get my groove on. I wanna get my body on. I wanna feel my body, baby. I wanna feel the rhythm.
Hi everybody, thank you, and thank you. That was the marvelous groove. Funkalicious! Okay, when you want some delicious funk, look up Funkalicious. I have to say one thing. Italy 2000 just had to release one of their most valuable people, Mr. Quincy Jones Jr. How you doing, Quincy?
I'm good, buddy. What's up?
Not much. I'm glad you could take the time out from your busy designer full day to come and wish us Happy Father's Day.
Of course I came to wish everybody Happy Father's
Day. Well, thank you.
Yeah.
What would you. And you have a beautiful daughter, too. Out, he was in Orlando, got past the massacre, thank God.
I made it back. I made it back safely.
That's right. So, anyway, oh, there you. Let me. Okay, here we go. All right, can we get this picture?
Oh, you blinked it out.
Oh, well, re-blink me.
There you go. You
okay. There she is. Looks just like Daddy. Yes, she does. All right.
Yes, my little princess.
Oh, she was wonderful. We got the chance to video talk to her. In
I know,
Orlando?
It was fun, wasn't it?
It was.
Yes, I'm still tired. I'm still tired.
Okay. Look right anyway. There. There you are. See? There we are. Okay.
So
talk to me. Tell me what Italy 2000 is going to do specially for me for Father's Day. A nice new chaise lounge or a lamp or, you know. Tell us what Italy 2000 is that you're designing appeal.
I think for Father's Day, they're probably going to have a nice little special sale.
Okay.
Yeah. Definitely for fathers. Maybe some 10, an extra 20% off. Something like that. Nice.
Okay.
Bring you in. Even okay. Veterans, too. I got to get them in, too.
Oh, wait. It's veterans.
Just, yeah.
Yes. Veterans, we got a special discount for you. Tell us where the store is located.
755 North La Brea, right on the right-hand side of Pink's.
Very good.
So you can't miss it. It's in between Melrose and Santa Monica.
There you go. Right there on La Brea. Italy 2000. And I must say, pizza, lasagna, Ferrari. We just about to know that. And I speak next to Alatino.
You come here for the hot furniture.
That's it.
You come here for
it. That's it, the hot furniture.
Oh, yeah.
That's it. Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to share? Would you like to shout out
to
anybody
I
special?
I love you, but this phone is vibrating so much, I got to go back.
I know.
I have too many clients actually waiting for me right now.
I'll see you later. Q, thank you so much for coming. Right. Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day. Thank you, buddy. Oh, I love you.
You too. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. Freddie? Okay. Hi there, everybody. I'm back. That was Quincy. So anyway, my next guest was the beautiful music that you heard before, and we're going to take it away with Fred Imes from Funkalicious. Fred.
Man, you're supposed to say Freddie Sweet, baby.
Fred is Sweet, baby, from Funkalicious.
A.K.A. Freddie Sweet of the band Funkalicious. And we are
Freddie.
Funky. The new generation of funk, baby. That's who we are.
Okay, Freddie, we've known each other back for how many years with E.J. Jackson? 5 years. 5 years?
Yeah, 5 years.
At least 5 years.
We've been knowing each other longer than that.
I know.
Yeah, but.
Oh, man, we go back to, okay, anyway, we were just babes.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, exactly. Fred, what's the most important function of Funkalicious this day?
Most important function is to get people to understand where a certain type of music came from. We represent funk music, you know, and as kids, our parents played funk music, and we all fell in love with it. And when I started the group, I asked a lot of the guys if they wanted to be in the band, and they said, yeah, everybody in this band has played with someone major. So our love for funk music, it just took off. And our message is really Jerry can tell you the message.
Well, introduce the member. Hey, you work with him every day.
I introduce the
members.
Come on,
Fred.
I have to introduce the members.
You got to.
Okay, right here next to me, this one right here. No, I'm just playing. his name is James Teddy Bear Jesse. On percussion, lead and background vocals. Right here is... Jamal Lamaze. He's lead and background. Next to him is Jerry Chocolate Q.
All right.
Daniels, music director and guitar player. Okay, sitting over there is the most vivacious. That's our manager, Taja Carlos.
Hi, Taja.
And sitting
Hi,
next everybody. To her is Lemon Drop.
Woo! Lemon Drop in the house.
I'm just playing. That's George Malone on leading background vocals and keyboards. And next to him, our professional roller skater and dancer, Dr. Quincy Reynolds.
All right, Dr. Quincy, get over there in the thing so we can see. I like that purple outfit. You rocking it, Doc.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Okay. So, when's your next performance?
Our next performance is actually next month. We're supposed to have been performing in Vallejo, but we don't know if that's happening right now, because what we did, we kind of shut everything down so we can finish our music. We're in the studio right now trying to finish up our music. We're trying to work out a distribution deal or a label deal, whatever comes first. So we said, you know what, we need to stop right now and finish up our products, because we were just spinning our wheels and putting CDs out, and we looked up, it was over 20,000 CDs we actually sold on our own.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
And
wow.
Awesome. So we said, you know what, we need to stop. Let's stop so we can finish our music. And that's where we're at right now. We have shows pending almost every month. Mm-hmm. We just did the Martin Luther King celebration and for the city of Inglewood, sponsored by KJLH.
Ah.
The Forum, it was in January. So then we were doing other shows, and then we said, you know what, we need to stop. We need to rehearse and get our show even bigger and better than where it is now. So that's where we're at right now. We just put everything on hiatus so we can try to get our music finished.
Okay. Well, let me ask you, what would it take to finish your music?
Oh, you already know that.
I just want to ask that question, okay? You see,
Donettos. We need Donettos.
Well, see, everybody needs money. Okay?
It's buying you.
Which brings me to a point. I mean, it's Father's Day. We have to provide for our families. So here's my question. Why are you going to perform at EJ's? Have you asked EJ yet?
We've been asking EJ for years to actually do a performance. You know how EJ, we just doing the turkeys. Look, you know I do a good EJ. You get over there and pass out the turkeys. What you doing? How you doing?
Okay. Well, I think we're going to do something special. I want everybody out there to go to the website, www.cyberspacemediabroadcastnetwork.com. I know it's a long one. I know it's long. Just go to my Facebook. Right there, Facebook, Alatito B. Brown. The network is there. Or call in and let us know if you'd like to pay to hear Funkalicious perform. We're going to put on another record. What's your favorite record that you have up there that you sit to? Oh, now you don't know.
Ooh, I can't say that one.
It's all of them.
No, they're all so good.
There you go. It's all of the above.
All right, give me another record, DJ, while we go to the next one.
DJ, pick out one that he like.
Dig one out. There you go. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen.
I got to be biased with our music.
Well, we got to get paid for it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So give me the best one.
She put her hand
Wonderful, guys. Oh, man, I can't wait to cut and overdub this one. Okay. We had the whole house rocking. Okay, Fred, it's Father's Day, and I have something very special for someone to say just to you. Hit it.
All right, first off, I'd like to say happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there in Radio Land, but specifically, I'd like to say happy Father's Day to my father, Freddie Sweet. Also, like to give a shout out to all the fathers in the band, Jesse,
Daddy Bear,
Chocolate Q, Mr. Malone, and Pimp Q.
Pimp Q.
Pimp Q. Hey, it's going out to everybody. Happy Father's Day.
All right, thank you. Yeah. All right. So thank you for coming on the show. Break the fucking rule. We got, we get funky. You guys want to come back and do this again one day on the instruments, or you want to do a live set on the red carpet?
It don't matter what.
It's going to have to be a live set.
That'd be awesome.
Whatever
we do, baby,
we're
going to make it fun.
It's going to
be
live. It's going to be fun. They're going to eat it up. Yeah. All right, Fred, thank you so much. Come on. All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll tell you this other stories later on about how far we go back. But ladies and gentlemen, Funkalicious, you got to give an event win to raise funds for who? Aside from, here it is. Give us the info.
Real quick. Let me read it. www.crowdrise.com Funkalicious. See, they wrote on here, any amount will do.
Okay, there you go. Amen. Every little bit helps.
Wait, it said donate $129,000
to win an iPod.
To win an iPod.
Okay. No, I'm excited.
All right, we're going to put this all up on my website. Okay. And now we're going to cut to our sponsors for a minute here. Another off-going song about Funkalicious. Hit it.
Thank you.
Right.
Thank you.
Funkalicious.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see you guys live.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pitbull energy drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.
Hi there, everybody. Let's back in the studio here. Okay, man, that energy drink felt good. Listen, Sonia.
Yeah.
What's up?
What's up?
Well, Rocket to the Stars has a new guest. Right, I say the best for last.
Okay, I love that.
Okay. I want to introduce a Rocket. His uncle is a rock and roll legend. Okay?
Okay.
Your name's Steven, right?
Steven, yes.
Okay. Steven's uncle was a rock and roll legend. I'm going to let you introduce. Take it away. This is your second guest for Rocket to the Stars.
Rocket to the Stars. Blasting off with Steven. I am so excited today. Steven, I am looking at you right now in this black You are shining like the stars, which is perfect because it goes right with the title of our show. So you have an uncle that is an amazing guy.
Well, actually, it's a relative, a cousin of mine, not my uncle.
Oh, he's a cousin of yours? Yeah. Okay, great. Well, that would mean that you have this amazing blood running through your veins as well, right?
Yes.
I would assume, yes. Okay, so who is this person that we're talking about? Who's this cousin of yours?
Well, a lot of people know him as Elvis Presley. I myself, I'm Stephen Presley. You can't escape the guy. I couldn't escape him growing up as a child either. So, very interesting lineage.
Yeah, that is super cool. It is a good lineage. And so, tell me this: with him being your cousin, when you were growing up, did you know that you wanted to do music? Was it always in you, or did you see your cousin and say, "Hey, I think I might want to do that"?
Well, to be honest with you, in the culture that I grew up in, it was all about church and your whole social background and everything. Every event was inside of the church. So Elvis was kind of like, you know, we saw him at the soda shop, the fountain shop. We never really thought much about it because there's a lot more than one Presley there. But I've always done music, from boys choirs to National Honors Chorus to singing opera.
Okay.
All kinds of things.
That is so cool. I'm glad that you mentioned that church. You grew up in church. So did you grow up like in a strict church? Because my parents were pastors too. Mm. I couldn't even watch television. What about you? Was it that strict for you? Or like, I mean, because having a Christian background is definitely, for the most part, going to make you somewhat musical. You know what I mean? It's really definitely going
to
make you musical because, you know, you have that in the morning service, midday service, and you have, you know, the youth services, the youth choir. You have all these different things that you're doing, right? So obviously you were integrated in music from a very young age if you grew up in church like that. Yeah.
Everything, like, even if you hear a majority of artists, even like New Kids on the Block,
okay,
Jordan Knight, all those guys, they'll sit there and tell you that they learned how to sing originally was from singing in the choirs in the church. So
I like that. I like that. I think that's where you get the real soul and connection with the people. It puts you in front of an audience that's there to actually feel what you're doing and not so much see what you look like.
Well, it's the it factor. It is the it factor in music, is having a soul inside of your music.
I love
Amen.
That. Yes,
That's
I do.
Very good.
And we are so close to Father's Day. Do you want to, like, do a shout-out to your dad by chance? Happy Father's Day?
I would love to. That's actually even more so than being a relative of Elvis Presley. I am even more proud to be the son of Michael Presley.
Woo-hoo!
All right.
Yes.
Like
and,
that.
And my grandfather who passed away, Ralph Presley. And this is my actual first Father's Day. So
that was my next question, so I'm glad that you answered it for me.
Yeah.
Right on time.
Yeah. So where are you, where can we catch you performing?
Where can you catch me perform? I'm actually right now in the writing stages on two albums.
Okay.
And I've been working on some tracks for film as well. So right now it's kind of like my reclusive, you know, the stage in which I'm building the next performance. So a lot of tracks and stuff will be coming out. It's kind of more of a to be announced.
To be announced type
but
thing.
Where you will find me
okay.
is I also have the show going on that Mr. Dick Michaels is putting on called Win the Jam Hollywood.
Okay.
Which basically there's going to be selling pins and people have an opportunity. They have an opportunity to actually get a record deal. So,
oh, really? Wow. Oh, I love that. That is so awesome. So,
and here it is right here, ladies and gentlemen.
Ah, that's awesome. I love it.
And just to let you guys know a little bit
jam.
About this.
Okay.
A little bit about this is that it's going to have, like, everything that you can think of as far as hats, T-shirts. The pins is actually can be, like, a memento, something you can keep as well. If you're a band that wants to join in, it's only $5 for a pin. But just to let you know a little thing about a couple of the people on there, including myself, okay. Mr. Russ Reagan that you see on there, he actually is the guy that discovered Elton John. He has also sold 8 billion records.
Wow.
He's the
president
of Uni. He was the president of a couple of major record labels. Really an industry icon. I'm very excited to be working with the crew that I'm working with right now.
Well, that's good. You know, that makes me excited. I'm actually really intrigued with the fact that since your cousin is Elvis, right? So I'm looking at you and I'm envisioning, I'm trying to place, where would you put your music? If I were to listen to your music, does it have any type of Elvis elements to it, or is it completely different, or like
none
you know?
Whatsoever?
Okay.
None whatsoever. I started out probably much like yourself. I'm I am a rocker in a lot of ways, right, but on. I do a lot of organic instruments as well as piano, as well as building electronic elements as far as orchestration. So if you put it in there, I would say if people like A Perfect Circle,
uh-huh,
or they like Chevelle, or they like even the pop aspects of that and Nine Inch Nails, you would probably start getting
into it. Ew, I love Nine Inch Nails. So do you play? You play instruments, yeah?
Yeah, I play instruments, and I produce and write music. I play the guitar and the piano.
Okay, great.
Right? Those are the perfect instruments to write.
That is,
you know,
true.
What I mean?
Especially the piano is my main writing tool.
It's kind of hard to write a song to the bass.
Oh, just play the piano.
No,
did he really?
Yes, you did.
Oh, right on. Okay.
Well, we have a couple minutes here. Let me bring on one other guest. Since it's the Father's Day theme, I'm going to adopt a new dad. Dig Michaels, come on over here.
Yay!
All right.
Come on in.
This is the legendary Dig Michaels. Come on right here. Okay, I need you over here.
Oh, there.
Oh yeah, here's the chair. Here's the chair. Here we go. All right, here we go. Have a seat.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay. Woo, woo.
Got it?
Woo. Yeah.
You guys hear that music? I can hear it.
All right.
Yeah.
Dig, hold on 1 second. I need you. Come in a little closer. I promise I won't bite you. See yourself right there?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Okay, stay close to me.
Yep.
Okay, there we go. Okay, Dig Michaels. Here you go. Look right here. Dig, right here. Okay, right there.
Okay.
There's the camera. How you doing? All right. Dig Michaels, there we go. Okay, Dig, happy Father's Day.
Thank you.
Thank you for so hanging out with me downtown L.A., the Prince concert, inviting me to your shows. Now, and bringing Stephen Pressley with you.
Yes.
That was very amazing. I appreciate that. I'm sure... Sonia, it was amazing to know that. I know a few rockers too, baby.
Yeah, right on. This is super cool.
Okay. So, Dick, tell us a little bit of how you and Steven are going to bring Johnny Dark, the music
legend. Johnny
legend.
Dark is part of my show.
Okay.
He's the host of the show.
Okay.
Yeah, and Johnny I've known for many years.
Okay.
And we're very good friends.
Okay.
And... And Johnny will be the actual host of the show.
Okay.
Stephen will be a major part in the show, both as an animated character and a regular, kind of an actor on the show.
Okay.
But we'll be launching his music,
mm-hmm,
and we'll be launching, you know, his career,
okay,
right now.
Is this like a television show?
Yes, it is a television show.
It's a television show. Awesome. Okay.
Yes.
Super cool.
And we will be giving a recording contract.
Okay.
Actually, a few of them. Giving
okay.
them.
Okay.
There's not a kind of a situation where you've got to be in front of a panel to get the chance.
Okay.
We're going to actually give it to them right there on the spot on television.
So if anybody wanted to get a hold and see your show, support your show, reach out to you, help support your show in any way, how would they contact you?
They could contact through the website.
Okay.
www.winthejamstars.com. And jam is spelled J-A-M-M.
J-A-M-M. So let me ask you a question regarding that. So the people who are... submitting to be a part of this Win the Jam thing, does it matter what genre of music that they're in? Win the Jam Hollywood.
Yes.
Does it matter what type of genre that their music or their band is?
We're only interested in bands or jammers. Bands are called jammers on the show.
Okay, right
on. It's only young bands, that we call them jammers on this show. Jammer number one, jammer number two. And by the way, which I have with me too, we're doing it for senior citizens.
Oh,
well.
Yay!
All right, yeah.
Awesome.
And
very good.
Which I have here too, by the way.
Okay. Okay.
So young
and the
jammers.
The host is Jeffrey Breslauer.
Okay.
And along with Chris Crosby, Bob Crosby's son, and Bing Crosby's brother, and Jimmy Rooney, Mickey Rooney's son, and also we've got And Jeffrey Breslauer is from the Muppets and from Jim Henson, and he's the host of that show. So Stephen will be in and out of that show too as well.
Okay.
So awesome.
Which will be a great blessing for everybody.
That's what we call a contract extension, right?
Exactly.
There you go.
Exactly.
Exactly.
And on the show that Stephen is on, we've got Teen Idol, Austin James Wolfe on.
Okay.
Oh, cool. Okay.
So,
awesome.
So we're moving along well, but I want to say this, that Stephen could say this. The way that his cousin grew up was through, you know, all he knows all about his early years and what his, you know, cousin is, you know, went through in his early years, and I wanted to bring that up, and which is a wonderful thing that the country should know now, which of course Stephen can talk about.
Stephen, you have 2 minutes to give us that wonderful introduction before we
all
go.
Right, well, there we
let's
go.
Let's do it. And if not, you can always come back and fill us in on the rest of it.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, okay. I mean, really, the point is that I actually grew up the same lifestyle, grew up in the same type of small church. Mm-hmm. What's funny is even his dance moves that were so provocative were really learned from Pentecostal ministers that were jumping pews and dancing and singing in the Southeast
right.
on stage. But yet it was so provocative that it was like, oh, this is not good, from the very same people that would be doing that on Sunday night. So I grew up totally in that, and I know exactly what it's like sitting on the porch, doing the porch talk, playing the music. You see the glam, the glitter, the sparkly jacket and all that. In truth, a lot of times growing up is sitting on a porch with a guitar by yourself at night.
Bingo.
That's where it's all at, where it all begins.
Right. Well, you know, like I said, Hollywood gives you that bigger-than-life appearance, you know, and the glitter and everything. I get that. But what is most important is where your heart is,
that's
where
right.
your soul is coming from.
That's right.
Because without your heart and soul, you got no rock and roll, baby.
No,
that's
you
right.
don't.
I agree with you.
You know, and without the greats, you got no rock and roll. Like, everybody would,
that's it.
You know, on that circuit, hang around each other and learn things that's from each right. other, right?
And that's the one thing I like about our group. My hands are off to Freddie J. Sacramento, because Freddie J. knows how to do it, okay? Freddie, I thank you for a lot that you've done over the past weeks in getting this together. And we're going to get even better, you know? Mac Brown, thank you so much for engineering the board as well. Alpheus, there you go. Alpheus, we're all getting together. We're starting out fresh and brand new. Bear with us. We're going to get a better and better show every other week. Thank you so much for tuning in. Giovanni, thank you so much for coming. Your mom, Dr. Frankie's
yes.
left.
Yay.
Sonya, thank you for joining me.
Oh, you're welcome.
Dick Michaels, Funkalicious, Quincy Jones Jr.,
Quincy
Rodney
Jones
Allen
Jr.,
Rippey, we don't know what happened. We'll see you next time. All right.
And Stephen Presley.
And Stephen Presley. Thank you so very much for coming. I wasn't going to forget you.
Oh, no, don't worry about it.
Okay, we're going to go out, take some pictures. It'll be up on Facebook. Look for us at CyberspaceMediaBroadcastNetwork.com. Look for my daughter, Sonya Harley, in Rocket to the Stars, okay? Soon as she gets on her P's and Q's. Right, sweetheart?
Yes. I'll be on it. It's going to be happening, you guys, and I expect for all of you guys to be there with us.
Thank you so much. Love you all. Happy Father's Day, everyone. Have a great day. Thank you.
Bye.